After three stages of intense racing at the Absa Cape Epic, the overall GC contenders appeared to cause something of a truce on stage four in the Breda River Valley. Investec Songo specialised Sauser and Kulhavy nursed their 7-minute 21-second lead over Topi Gergon in the best possible way by spending the entire 111 kilometres in the company of their closest rivals Lecadre and Heineck. This allowed the battle for the Absa Africa jersey to take centre stage. Starting the day nearly 7 minutes behind category leaders Lil and Wilcock, the Scott Factory Racing pair of Philip Bass and Matthijs Bierkes attacked inside the first 10 kilometres. The fiercely determined cross-country specialists opened up a lead of over 7 minutes on the rest of the field. Ready Blends Wilcock and Lil did all they could to hang on to the chase pack and minimise their losses, whilst the young USN team of Raul Kruse and Travis Walker limited their time losses as best they could in order to defend their third place in the category. Over the last 20 kilometres, Topi Gergon drove the pace in the hunting pack, but Bass and Bierkes were able to hang on for a famous victory by 3.5 minutes to become the third team to wear the Absa Africa jersey this week. No change at the top of the men's overall leaderboard after stage four. Investec Songo Specialized still lead Topi Gergon by 7 minutes and 21 seconds. Scott Factory Racing now lead Wilcock and Lil by 2 minutes and 5 seconds. In the Sasol women's race, Kleinhans and Langvad of Riesem Specialized won their third stage and have managed to claim back 56 minutes over two stages. They lead Stenerhag and Groot by just under half an hour. Wessel and Kraft lead the mixed. Former leaders Hasselbach and Sommer only 4 minutes ahead of Essa and Williamson. A minute and 25 separates the top two teams in the Dimension Data Masters, and Bucher and Zorbeck have 49 minutes in hand in the Grand Masters. Stage 5 takes the riders from Worcester to Wellington. Their first major challenge, power lines, a climb that'll keep them on the tips of their saddles. The track then veers across the beautiful Wolseley Valley and onto the national monument that is Bainscruith Pass. Finally, their award, Velvet Pass Trail, some of the very best single track in the world. Recovery is perhaps the most important factor for a successful Absa Cape Epic, and thanks to Woolworths, the riders are able to begin their recovery programs as they get off their bikes. The retail giant has been an integral part of the race for many years, and not only do they provide the riders with a nutritious lunch pack and a hot meal, they also have a cool, comfortable lounge area where they can get off their feet and either lick their wounds after a particularly tough day or share war stories with fellow riders. The Absa Cape Epic is widely regarded as one of the toughest endurance events in the world, and for good reason. Falls and injuries are part and parcel of the sport of mountain biking. The Mediclinic Mobile Hospital is one of the most critical areas in the race village. Under the experienced eye of Dr. Jan Killips, a team of doctors and nurses tend to riders' injuries from grazes, bumps, bruises and saddle sores to serious fractures, dehydration and heat exhaustion and plenty more. The world-class facility is equipped to deal with any medical eventuality. Worcester in the Breda River Valley, a region steeped in history. This week, the battleground of the Absa Cape Epic, the calm before the storm. Today's stage earmarked as the day on which the race could be won or lost.
Yeah, for sure. We are looking for wins. We are looking for a stage win, but it's not easy. When you are focusing the overall, it's quite hard to be winning because right now the specialized guys, the Songo guys, they have a superior level than us. So we are really, we need to be really conscious about our energy, and we have to use it in the right moment. As you say, if we see that today is opportunity and I feel good in my body, so we will try for sure.
It's actually the last long stage, so this is maybe the time to get a little bit more time back on the GC, but it will be tough, but we try everything today, and we see the first shorter climbs, maybe we can get away or whatever, and then it's a long flat section that maybe Jaro can chase back, but we try to put them under pressure, and that's the goal today.
Yes, we're still fighting for the podium and overall. Yesterday we could make a bit time to the Merida boys, and we hope we can today go back for the third place. Today is the last long stage, and I think we have to do it today.
Yeah, they know the most important will be at the beginning and towards the end, the beginning, because you have to get your legs going after a few days of racing, feeling good, and then hopefully towards the end it really suits us. We actually won the Epic 2 years ago on that last end.
New wearers of the red Absa Africa leaders jerseys after daring attack early on stage four, Scott Factory Racing. Leaders in the Sasol Women's Riesem Specialized. The start gun sets them off. The front row of the grid displaying each of the category leaders. Yellow for men, orange for Sasol women, blue for Dimension Data Masters, green for mixed and purple for Grandmasters. With 275 kilometers still to race over three more days, there's a long way to go. And with 117 kilometers and 2,500 meters of climbing, it promises to be another epic battle today. The red dust, characteristic of the region, paints a spectacular landscape of endeavor at the biggest mountain bike stage race in the world. The flat, wide open roads in the first few kilometers gives the privateers a chance to hang on and ride in the front group with some of the best athletes on the planet, world champions and Olympic medalists among them. Heads of state in Vestek-Songo specialized lead out affairs of the day. Absa Africa jersey wearer Scott Factory Racing are marked closely by Ready Blend and Team USN. Nerves in the pack and a crash. Eric Kleinhans goes down, a threat to Vestek-Songo's specialized backup team. A momentary lapse in concentration and a touch of elbows between Kleinhans and Masters contender Jose Rosa. The fall brings down a few others, including Stefan Salm's partner Timo Cooper. Straightening the bars, quick check of vital signs, and they're off again. Hoping to make an impact today, Raw Cruiser, South Africa's cross-country champion, no doubt inspired by Philip Bass and Matthijs Bierke's victory on stage four. Both Cruiser and Walker will be competing on the UCI World Cup circuit this year. Bierkes keeps a close watch on the efforts by USN, defending red by keeping Cruiser and Walker in check. Leaders in the Sasol Women's RCM Specialized, Ariane Kleinhans and Annike Langvad. Another fast start for the Swiss-Danish pair. A start list in the front group, Cruiser, Walker, Platt, Sauser, Kulhavy, Lakata, all the main contenders present and correct. The majestic Vaihook Mountains, standing watch over the line of riders, thinning out with the pace set by USN. And they're away, Cruiser and Walker, best African team of the prologue, wearing red for 3 days. As cross-country specialists, the pair are more accustomed to 90-minute intense racing, a huge difference from the diesel-style efforts required to succeed at what would be a 100-kilometer-plus escape. Local fans will be cheering these two young riders, following the live updates on official Twitter handle at Absa Cape Epic. Ariane Kleinhans leads Annike Langvad, the world marathon champion, in another all-out effort. They already have 7 minutes on their chasers, RBS's Teresa Ralph and Jeannie Bonfadrea. Ralph is a former podium finisher at the race. The 40-year-old has completed the Absa Cape Epic four times. Next team on the road is Ascender's Health. Consistent effort in defending second overall by Robyn de Groot and Jennie Stenerhag. USN hold their own with the main field breathing down their necks. A flat for Topi Gergen. This is the reason they brought along a backup team, Menon and Bishop. Rather than risk a makeshift temporary repair, they'll make a swap donation of wheels and get back on the trails in pursuit as quickly as possible. Menon and Bishop are left to deal with the damage. Kulhavy is on the front, keeping the pace high, USN's advantage diminishing on the climb. One more chance to open the gap on the downhill. They'll take some chances, it's worth the risk. No favours from Kulhavy, the Czech is in kill mode. With the Olympic champion's bike handling skills, it's a tall order for USN just to stay away, let alone gain time. The carrot is close. Thanking Kulhavy for his pace setting is Scott Factory Racing, defending the red jersey for moves such as USN's. Lady Luck has overlooked Topi Gergen this morning. Even their newly donated wheel is losing air. They fight on regardless. Carl Platt follows the tempo set by Vestek-Songo Specialized, his form improving towards the end of a hard week. His partner Ushuba, however, is struggling on the steep climbs. the Day Tripper Riders in support, the program offering guests a chance to experience the route and the race firsthand. Uber is not able to match the pace on the climb. And Philip Bass is showing the effects of his and Bukas' monster lone breakaway on stage 4. There's a strong all-African contingent on the front group, Scott Factory Racing, Ready Blend, USN and EAI. Eric Kleinhans, a small sign of his crash earlier on his elbow. Topi Gergen are on the rampage back to the leaders, looking to defend second position overall. On board with Jaroslav Kulhavy, who pulls over with a leaking tyre. Almost immediately, the mobile spares department of Eric Kleinhans and Nico Bell, Team RCM, swap the wheel.
I'm not sure. I think you might have just hit a rock on the downhill and just damaged the wheel a bit, so we just had to change it. But the jockey went past the push lock, so we had to just bend it back to get the chain tensioned again. So now obviously he's on his way. So
Platt is all business. Sauser, though, has come to a halt to wait for his partner as race rules dictate.
I think a chain problem is coming, I think. Is it coming?
What's happening, Susie?
There had something in his a stick or something. No, I just really hope he's coming. I'm not allowed to ride back. Come on, Jaro, please, man. Kommt Jaro?
Nein, jetzt ist er mit dem Schalter.
Okay, backup is there, but I can't go back.
Must be frustrating.
Very. Now the top peak is coming. Well, let's just have a little break, but Eric is a good mechanic, especially also Nico Bell. Hope it's not going to be a drama.
Sauser can hardly look as Topi Gergen fly past, but Jaroslav Kulhavy is back on track again. Judging by his performances this week and by his nickname, the Czech Express, he'll make short work of getting back to the front. Nico Bell, a job well done. The bike shop owner is a virtuoso mechanic as well as a top pro mountain biker. Carl Platt drives the race, all under control for Bukas. Absa Africa Challenge's Ready Blend look good too. USN and EAA not so much. Sauser keeps a moderate tempo to allow teammate Jaroslav Kulhavy to get back. Just when Topi Gergen thought they'd had their allotted misfortunes for the day, an unshipped chain on Lakata's bike. In the heat of the moment, it takes what seems like an age to unravel. Not only do these top endurance athletes require a massive cardiovascular system and razor-sharp bike handling ability, they need to be able to make rapid emergency repairs with the skill of a trauma surgeon. Finally, Lakata gets it done all on his own. His partner, Christian Heineck, is up the trail waiting. Finally, Lakata arrives at the water point. They'll head to the tech zone to make a more sustainable repair. Lakata's twisted chain needs a full replacement. The new chain is the only solution, retrieved from one of the team's pre-packed tech boxes. These are transported to the tech zones each day. Only the riders can work on their bikes. The clock ticking, precious time lost by Topi Gergen. Meanwhile, Jaroslav Kulhavy and Christoph Sauser are back for the front group, thinned out in the efforts of Carl Platt on the steep, rough climbs. Topi Gergen smashing the pedals as they chase back. They sweep by Multiband Merida and Reese M. Two men on a desperate mission. The vast expanse of the route that makes the Absa Cape Epic what it is. All involved, from riders to the crew, the race is eternally grateful to the landowners who kindly grant permission for access year after year. It's Investec Songo Specialized, the Bulls Ready Blend and EAI, a great showing for the South Africans among the top riders in the world. The sharp end of the race approaches Bain's Kloof Pass, another historic feature of the Absa Cape Epic. Topi Gergen go flat out. Christian Heineck won the 2014 race as a rookie, partnered with Robert Menon. But even with a powerful partner like Lakata, the team are no match for the cruel hand of fate. Christoph Sauser takes the opportunity to eat. Riders try and get as much fuel on board during the stage. Bain's Kloof Pass, a national monument. The tarred surface, a welcome respite from the rough tracks of the last 5 days. Towing the Bulls, Ready, Blend and Team EIA is four-time champion Christoph Sauser. Christian Heineck and Alvin Lakata power up 3 minutes off the front group. The pass is the link between the Breda River Valley and the Boerland region. Andrew Geddes-Bain oversaw the building of this regional road using convict labour. Remarkably, the Scot achieved this feat without any formal training. On the descent, the frontrunners have Wellington in their sights. It's a lonely day out for the Czech-Austrian pair. The leaders off the pass and head up the final obstacle of the day. The upper steep tracks above the single track of Velvenpass. EAI are off the back. Superb ride today by Ready Blends Lil and Wilcock. If they keep this up, they'll earn their first podium place ever at the race. A familiar sight. Investec Songo Specialized forces the pace with a few kilometers to go, and they gap the last riders able to hang on. Platt is able to match, but waits for Huber, who is not at his best today. Christian Heineck performs best on the long climbs. He sets the rhythm, keeping Topi Gergen in the game. Jaroslav Kulhavy turns over a massive gear. The gap back to Ready Blend extends. The South African pair hang tough on their best day out ever on the mountain bike. Into the swooping single track descent go Investec Songo Specialized. The pair have over 7 minutes on Topi Gergen, a comfortable margin at this point of the week. Still, they leave nothing to chance. It's up to Heineck and Lakata to take all the risks on their way down. The Bulls have overhauled Ready Blend. As a junior, Platt was a national downhill champion. He's clearly not forgotten any of his skills. The German-Swiss pair are fourth overall, 2 minutes behind Multiband Merida. With today's performance, a spot on the overall podium looks more likely. They're gaining tracts of time on Hermida and Van Hoots. Emerging from the canopied single track, Lil and Wilcock fly down the Velvenpass trails that entertain thousands of local riders each weekend. On Sunday, these two local lads hope to be wearing the Absa Africa jerseys. Wellington awaits the first riders to arrive. A fourth stage win for Investec Songo Specialized. Another stellar display of firepower, skill, teamwork and cool-headedness from Jaroslav Kulhavy and Christoph Sauser. The Bulls charge home, wanting to gain every second on podium rivals Multiband Merida behind them. Huber thanks his partner Platt. And a first ever podium place at the world's biggest mountain bike stage race for Ready Blend's Darren Lill and Waylon Wilcock. This will be a day to remember for the South Africans. Clever tactics on stage four, not to chase Scott Factory Racing and rather maintain a consistent effort. It's all paid off with them reclaiming red. The Bulls, as always, bravely fighting all the way to the very end. In the Sasol women's category, it is business as usual for Ariane Kleinhans and Annike Langvad, gaining time steadily on their rivals. RCM Specialized are in a class of their own. Team RBS, Teresa Ralph and Jeannie Dreyer Bomford, building on yesterday's improved performance. Ever consistent Team Ascenders helps Jennie Stenerhag and Robyn, confident on the technical trails in the Breda River Valley. But no one could stop Ariane Kleinhans and Annika Langvaart. They're a truly phenomenal combination. They won 7 out of 8 stages in 2014 and 5 out of 6 so far this year, today by 23 minutes.
Today the luck was on our side, and also I felt pretty strong today. So last days I had to suffer a lot and hanging in, and today I felt great, and that's fun to race.
I was so relieved to get onto the tar section, coming from a road background. It just felt more at home, and could actually recover more than anything on the tar road, being even though it was uphill. I'm just nervous about what was lying ahead of us. Still two steep climbs towards the end, but like Darren said, I also know the route. I'm from Stellenbosch, so not far from my backyard. And just flipping over the moon to finish on the podium on the stage.
A characteristic surge over the last 15 kilometres sealed another impressive stage win for the race leaders. Team Bulls had their best day of the race so far, as did Ready Blend, who are back in the Absa Africa leaders' jerseys. Try as they might, no other team in the Sasol women's race was able to make an impression on the dominant RiceM specialised combination. De Villiers and Stefkova had a superb day to finish third. Peter Vessel and Yvonne Kraft added 6 minutes to their mixed lead, and the Dimension Data Masters was a sprint finish, Brentjens and Azevedo taking the win. Bucher and Zorbeck won their sixth stage in a row in the Grand Masters. Investec Songo Specialized have just under 11 minutes in hand with two stages to race. The Bulls have climbed back into the top three, and Ready Blend have reclaimed their Absa Africa red jerseys. RiceM Specialized are now 53 minutes clear of Ascenders Health to Groot and Stenerhag. Despite a poor day today, Sus and Pirard still in third place overall. Vessel and Kraft looking comfortable in the mixed lead. The Dimension Data Masters is thrilling. A minute and 26 seconds split the top two, and Bucher and Zorbach in little danger in the Grand Masters. Stage 6 is a beauty and the beast experience. There's Velvin Pass with more of its incredible single track, but the Pig's Peak and Moonwalker climbs are intense. Roller Coaster, Point Break and Heaven's Gate single track will take them home with smiles on their faces.